another Sunday. What's going on, guys? It's Talking at the Movies. Woohoo!
Hey! Yeah, finally. Woke up, Mo.
Why are you two so happy?
It's We're presenting.
There's no Game of Thrones tomorrow. Aren't you in withdrawal?
No, but there's other tonight. TV shows.
Tonight, tomorrow.
It's over. Don't worry, there's still others.
It's Preacher's getting good now. Sad.
Preacher's getting good now, so.
It's okay. We could just one day just sit around, call each other, and just talk about the show.
Yes, guys. For you at home listening, this is Talking at the Movies, episode 20, I believe. There or thereabouts. Jesus, I'm losing track.
That's
of
really
shit.
Bad. You believe? Don't even know.
Yes,
it's 21.
You just made out. I am joined, as you have noticed, by.
It cannot be 20.
Yes, lot 19 was the last one.
Was 19 the last one? Mm.
And who are you?
I don't know. I woke up this morning. I was like, who am I?
You woke up like this.
Where am I?
Introduce yourself.
I
am
Mo.
So we get into the news, or what have we been watching this week? Yeah, start out.
House of Cards.
We seem to all talk about House of Cards every week. Either you're talking about Asylum, or now you're talking about it.
I was talking about it when we first started.
Yeah, now you've finished it, but now he's just
but
got into
it. It's so compulsive. I have done 9 episodes over 3 days, and 2 of those days I only watched 1 each.
It's one of those shows,
man. It is. It is so intelligent. It's so well written, and it's just compulsive viewing, and you've just got to watch what happens next.
What season is this,
so this is season 4.
Okay, yeah, I have to catch up on that one. I shall return to that, but we've got a couple of things I've still got to do. Friggin' the Marco Polo I've got to do. Friggin' Mr. Robot season 2 is just starting.
Oh, okay.
I think this week or next week, so
cool.
I'm gonna have to do that. And there's a whole, there's this new Netflix one as well, the one that's based in like the 80s, like a
Goldberg, yes,
Stranger
that
Things
just
or
came
something
out.
That's about to start this week.
That just came out of nowhere. I literally read about it on Thursday.
Oh, the trailers have been going for a couple of weeks, but yeah.
It does sound interesting.
So, well, okay. Why do you control me? Why
because
you
it's my turn. It's
you've
a
had
cycle.
Your turn. You know, finish.
Oh. Silent, you're like so eager to jump in to tell us what the one episode of TV you watched this week.
What's an episode of Family Guy? It's very funny.
Well, do I have a surprise for you guys?
He's watched 2 episodes.
I watched pretty much the whole season. I purposely have stopped at the last 2 episodes of Vikings.
Why?
Ooh, because it. When you see the end and you're enjoying it, you just don't want it to end. So I put it off. I just don't want it end. The last 2 days have just stopped.
That doesn't
stopped.
Make no sense.
I know, because
technically it's
because
ended.
I know it's there, and I know it's no, because it's still the second half of the season to come.
Yeah, but that's
so
just
I know that it's there, and I know that I can dip in anytime I'm feeling
low. But you
low.
Don't want someone to spoil it, and by telling you
no
that Rolo
watches,
dies.
Except for you. Except for you lot, no one else watches this show.
You should have seen Eddie's face. He just looked like he put his stab Mo in the eye.
No, I haven't spoiled it for anyone that's not watching.
But no one else watches this bloody show. It's just a freaking shame.
It is
a great show, man.
That really surprises me, actually, because you say to people, do you watch Vikings? And you say, who makes that? It's
yeah,
like History Channel.
They're like, huh? But it's a damn good show, man. Oh, what the fuck's happened to me? Look, that fucking Chinese chick turned him into a heroin addict. Oh my, well, spoiler alert for anyone who started watching it. But if you ain't watched this show, watch it. It's such a good show. If you need something to, it's not like Game of Thrones, but it kind of scratches that itch. Just about.
It's like Game
just
of
about.
Thrones light, but saying that actually is
a
disservice.
Yeah, no, that is a disservice, because that's how they freaking describe that other shitty MTV. Shannara Chronicles, that truly is a Game of Thrones light.
This is like, it just hasn't got the multi-threaded huge character cast.
Yeah, it's a tighter, smaller world.
But what it does it really well.
What a world, baby, what a world.
So, do I get to talk now? Okay, right. So, I have been watching, and I watched.
I didn't say yes.
4 episodes of Daredevil Season 2.
4.
Yes.
So what episode are you up to now?
So I'm 4. Up to so I'm on episode 7 now.
Okay, fine.
So I've met Elektra.
So should we have a moment of silence for Elektra?
Mm. Oh my god, Elektra's amazing. And I've just been introduced once again to Kingpin.
Oh,
yes. So it goes to visit. Is this the one? So I think Kingpin's in it a few episodes. So what's just happening?
So this is
one?
The very first time where Punisher meets Kingpin.
Ah, right.
Oh.
Yes.
Did you have the Punisher scene?
What? Which one?
Well, how did they meet?
At the very end, where he's lifting weights. And then you got my message,
indeed. See?
Yes.
If you were caught up, we could actually talk about the scene.
In the next episode.
So I'm watching that. But I took your advice, and I decided to watch Death Note, and I'm like 10 episodes in already.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. Oh my god, this show.
Really?
Yeah. 10 episodes straight in. It's something that I
really.
I swear down. I don't. Why are you looking at me
because
like that?
Because you lie.
I told
you. Lie.
How do I lie?
You lie. I used to lie
when we were at school. But this show, it's something that you touched upon.
This surprised me because I expected Mo to be the one to come this week and say that he'd watched Death Note, but he hadn't.
No.
It's
incredibly, incredibly good, and I can't wait. I'm a bit worried because there's a few glitches here and there that I see in it that I'm thinking to myself, how are they going to translate this in as a live action and do it properly, you know?
Well, they've done it live action before for the Japanese movies.
Yeah, but that didn't quite
they
work.
Aren't great, but they made a couple of them, so they were successful.
Yeah.
But yeah, they're going to adapt it. It's going to be based, you know, in the States.
Yeah.
So they're going to smooth out certain things. But yeah, it is a great show.
But it's the one show
it's
that
the cat and mouse, isn't it?
Yes, but it's the show that I watch, right? And I think to myself, it's the one show that I haven't come across in a long time. But I do ask the question that if I came in possession of that book, what exactly will my thoughts be? What would go through my mind? And that, what's that other thing called? The Shinigami or something like that?
Oh, the eyes.
Yeah, the dude that follows him around.
Oh, the death.
So it's all very exciting and very interesting. So guys, if you haven't seen Death Note, you must check this out.
Oh, your homework for next week.
I went looking for it. It's gone from Netflix. I could only find the dub version on YouTube.
I want to see
proper original language. None of this dubbing nonsense. No.
What's the original? It is beautiful. Beautiful show. Watch it, people. Because Netflix are remaking it. Shall we get into the news?
Let's go for it.
Let's do this.
Well, this is an article that I saw, and it's not so much who, but it was just the sum that caught my eye. So
How is this possible?
Colony has taken a grand total on its opening day, a Friday, £47.
So this is in the UK
this
cinema.
This is in the UK.
You have to keep in mind that it has been online.
Yes.
For a while.
Yes, that was in the article. So it's a combined streaming and a very limited cinema run. But £47.
When I mean it's online, I don't mean as a illegal streaming. I mean it leaked out a good month or two ago.
Oh, did it now? Ah.
A long time. But I was actually mentioning this when I was doing a trailer reaction to on my YouTube channel, The First Take. Go check it out, people. To Daniel Radcliffe's most recent movie, upcoming, where he plays this FBI agent that's going undercover with neo-Nazis in America. And I was actually saying that, surprisingly, he's the one that seems to be taking all of these interesting roles, because for a while, Emma Watson was looking like she was going to be the most successful out of the Harry Potter guys. But Radcliffe has just been taking interesting role after interesting role.
Yeah, but the other side to it is that, to be honest, this wasn't promoted that well. The marketing behind this was awful. Yeah. I didn't even know until I've seen the poster that even is... what was out in the cinemas. Just but 40 was that 46 pounds or
47 pounds?
£47 is just possible. I mean, how do you, like, what does she do from this point onwards?
She doesn't need to do anything. She's got friggin' Beauty and the Beast coming out this year.
Yeah, she has, yes.
And that's going to do gangbusters.
I think we touched upon this last week. They have made so much of money that they can afford to go out and do these smaller projects that probably might not be critical hits or even money makers.
Yeah, but the thing is, Daniel is doing that, but he's a good...
All the ones that I look back at, when it comes down to Daniels, they are very, very good.
Swiss Army Man looks great. It's getting good reviews.
Horns
was really good. Neo Nazi one looks really good. He had that one where he's the gay dude. It was really. He's just a.
Do you reckon Emma Watson's buddy said, "Listen, just star in this film, help me out," because I really don't understand. Like, does anyone know anything about it?
I don't. But she's had a few movies, and none of them have really...
Well, she was in Noah, so no one could have predicted that that would have been not particularly well received. I still haven't actually seen it, despite wanted to see it.
Wasn't that great, was it?
So... Oh, yes, Noah was one of those films that we seriously cussed off, didn't we?
The Perk of Being a Wallflower?
That was good. That one, okay, I take that back. That was a good film. That was a really good film, actually. Really good film.
The Bling Ring?
Not great.
This Is the End?
That was a tiny cameo. You can barely even... That was a great film.
Wait, you've been watching all of Emma Watson's library.
I watch films.
I know you watch films, but I didn't know you watched those films.
I watch all films.
Have you seen her appearance in The Vicar of Dibley?
Are you kidding me?
She's listed as being a Reverend Iris in one episode last year.
Last year?
Yeah. So that's still on the show.
Holy shit. So let's move into the heartbreaking news. Moment of silence. Truly, the Game of Thrones season 7 has been delayed.
Will not start in its usual March-April timeframe.
What's the what start date we got now?
Later in the year, basically, because it's winter now, so they don't need the sun.
Winter hasn't come. That's why.
Yeah, because usually they start filming the tail end of the summer.
Could you? Yeah, alright, okay.
And they don't need that weather now. Everywhere needs to be cold and rainy, and so it's all going to be shitty.
You would have thought all that stuff would just be CGI'd in. They wouldn't want people standing out beneath actual snow.
Some filters on the lenses to make it look darker and overcast.
They did it with like the battle at Winterfell with Stannis.
Most friggin'.
But let's not forget, there's other places that are sunny. So they could film those places. So I suppose they're going to take care of that.
Well, now that Daenerys is coming over and everybody's coming with her, they don't really need to do all of that in the sunny shit anymore. This is all Westeros now.
And because things are moving so fast, probably everything will just be Westeros.
Yeah, it's just all Westeros now. There's no one in. But all the other places, Dorne and... there's no one there. Everyone's here.
What about if winter has turned into summer and the snow walkers white walkers,
get it right,
snow walkers, white walkers are sunny walkers, we could do something crazy.
Would they be walking around drinking Sunny Delight
naked?
Could you imagine that
in like Hawaiian shirts and sunglasses?
That's Borat banana.
You mean the mankini?
But do you think it will make that bigger impact because it's a shorter season? So, it will start later, but it will still end around the same time.
And April seems to be a good time to bring a show on because all the big network stuff's coming to an end, or it's on hiatus, and there is no competition for this show. There's nothing else on. Most shows have had their season finals.
But it's for a reason, because nothing else can compete with this.
Well, that's what I was going to say. What can compete with
the show? About 7 episodes. Then a whole fucking another break.
Yeah, but it's fine if it's like good 7 episodes. I don't want to see this show dragged out. They've got an end game, they've got an end plan, they know where they're going. We'll get a satisfactory ending.
What I've been doing on my channel, I've started going into the history of Game of Thrones, these videos that talk about how everything started. Dude, holy fuck. They really could have started right from the very beginning. They could have done this show for years. It is wicked. Wicked.
But who knows? They may even do that. Once it's finished, think about where they could go with the show. Did we speak about that they're looking about doing some sort of show that's set?
Well, there are spin-off novellas about two knights, two sellswords that George R.R. Martin has written over the years. Little short stories. He's done a couple of them. And they're thinking about maybe basing a mini... sort of series or another show on those two guys. But I don't know about... But the history itself is wicked about how the Valyrians, as an actual race, where they come from, you know, where the Valyrian swords come from. It was an actual race of people. How the fucking Targaryens came to be. Like, all the history, the first men, children of the forest. This is just rich.
Oh, I mean, a lot
beautiful.
Of those stories you do get in the book.
But this is the full story of it.
Like you said, there's probably plans for a spin-off after this. They're probably milking this franchise for years to come.
Apparently, Jaws Takei, is that right?
Yep.
Ain't too happy about Sulu, the movie depiction of Sulu being gay.
This surprises me, seeing as Mr. Takei, A, is gay, B, he's also the happiest man in the internet, because whenever you see a post from him, it's always something charming and something funny. To me, this kind of sounds like there is no buzz. There is no buzz for this new Star Trek movie, and they're creating some.
Well, he's... Well, it's not really something you really want to cause issue with. You'd think that he'd be all for it. And it's Simon Pegg that's actually come out saying that he respectfully disagrees with George Takei's opinions on not wanting Sulu to be gay. Do you think he just doesn't want the character to be defined by the man that he is in real life?
So did George Takei, because I haven't actually read any of the articles, did he actually give any explanation? Or was he just
He said that the character originally wasn't supposed to be gay, so they shouldn't be turning him gay. Because it doesn't fit well with the original... Roddenberry's original interpretation of it. But they've done the
Spock and Uhura weren't lovers. Exactly. And they've changed that.
Yep.
Hey, you've got to set the show for like a modern audience. You can't have like... And if you've ever seen any of the documentaries about Roddenberry, you'll realise he's not all there either. He was a little bit of a strange person.
Cool.
Yes. Especially if you ever watch... There's a documentary on Netflix, which I highly recommend that you watch. It's all about the first couple of seasons of The Next Generation and Roddenberry's insane handling of that show.
Oh, was he actually still heavily involved in that?
Oh, he was heavily involved for the first couple of seasons, and they finally managed to actually get him off. And that's when the show dramatically improved.
Oh, shit.
I mean, he was still holding to things like no conflict, no battles, and all that sort of stuff. So if you watch the first couple of seasons of Next Gen compared to what came after... They're drastically different.
I think it's important to add layers on certain characters. They may not be weaker characters, but I think it's important to sort of just make them slightly a bit more exciting, especially if it doesn't work for the script at the time. So maybe that's what they did. But I don't see why he needs to go off on a tangent about it. Maybe you're right, actually. Maybe it's because the film has had like very little buzz. And that's why they've been doing it. Well, that's why he's brought it out.
There's been a lot of film flopping this year, do you reckon?
It's actually, let's talk about that for a because it is coming out this Friday. Is it this Friday? No, following Friday.
Following Friday.
Wait, is that worldwide though?
It's either worldwide it's or it's going to be within a few days.
I think this is a big enough film that it will be pretty consistent.
No buzz about this whatsoever.
Well, people have been talking about it, but it's not positively because they hated that first trailer.
It's not like... You know, like when a Marvel movie's coming out, when a DC movie, you know, it's like everywhere. There's adverts everywhere. There's like people on forums talking about
it. But it hasn't built that affection that Marvel have. Or it doesn't have that... It doesn't even really affect people the same way... Well, I guess it's hard to read. You shouldn't, even though people always do, compare it with Star Wars. But it's just... It's a whole different
beast. It's the closest sort of like comparison that you can make, but they are so totally different franchises. But it is such a shame because they have, in this movie, they've departed from what Star Trek is and they've tried to make it more Star Wars-like. Apparently that's what the executives want. I think this may well be the last movie with this cast because they've got a new series, TV series coming out in January. We may not see anything from this again.
But you think that's the Abrams?
I think Abrams...
Because he set the tone for what we're going to get.
The first movie, is extremely good. I really enjoyed that. That was like a good way to bring things kicking and screaming. The one thing I didn't like was they messed with the timeline so much and took away all of that history. All that was gone. In one way, I suppose, they're free and they're from the shackles of their past.
Yeah, that's what you'd want.
But on the second hand, it's kind of like there were so many interesting characters and stories that they could have built upon.
Yeah, but we saw with the second one, when they take those old stories, they fuck them up.
That was a terrible movie.
Yeah. You know, I'm optimistic to see how this... I actually still think it's going to be an enjoyable film, but whether it will do good...
But the thing is, the trailer actually looks... I saw it the other day again.
The most recent one, yeah.
Yeah, it looks good. It looks like a fun film.
It did.
But a lot of films haven't been doing well, even big ones. Tarzan apparently hasn't done particularly well.
Yeah. I think, what's that? On Rotten Tomatoes, just running under 50% at the moment.
Did no one feel offended with the new trailer, with having Rihanna as the soundtrack?
No,
because that's not very Star Trek like. Imagine having Star Wars and having like Jay-Z rapping across.
But didn't you say just a few minutes ago, like, it's important that, you know, with what's trending and what's happening at the time, and, you know, why not have her soundtrack on this very impactful.
Doesn't fit.
I actually saw the music video, the proper music video, before I saw her or heard her song in the trailer. And her music video, she's done up like an alien. So it wasn't. It didn't really take me away because I was in it from seeing her vision of it.
Well, what did you want? What music would you
want? I wanted like, you know, like
Michael Bublé.
Oh, now we're talking. Do you remember the first stars. Do you remember Abrams' Star Trek, the one that he directed? Yes. They had taken that theme from Dune, War Begins, and then like they went and redid it as a proper orchestral score.
But it will have orchestral score in the film. You're not going to hear Rihanna's singing.
It's not Star Trek.
Rihanna singing every time. This is a serious moment.
Oh no, here they come. Like, I know people in the first movie were really upset with like a Nokia ringtone and the Beastie Boys. I could get behind that because it was like a one-off. But now they're using like a modern-day track to push something that's like a couple of hundred years in the future.
Nah, it's only for the commercial though. It's only for the trailer. Yeah, it's not going to be in the actual film.
Yeah, you're a serious Trek fan. That's why you're getting offended about
too much. Extremely offended.
But you listen to Rihanna all the time.
I could name you one track.
Dude, this guy didn't even know until a couple of weeks ago who Drake was.
Well, he didn't even know who Ariana Grande was.
Fucking hell, man. You've unplugged from the world for way too long.
Mate, my music is very eclectic.
What if, right? Because you're a massive Michael Jackson fan.
Didn't know Drake was people. Fuck.
If there was the bad... Would you like it then?
If they made it into an orchestral score, why not?
Smooth Criminal.
Have you never heard the orchestral versions of Michael Jackson's tracks?
No, I can't say I have.
Listen to them. They are really good.
They're alright.
So you think
they're all right.
That a Star Trek movie scored with orchestral versions of
Michael Jackson? We're on to a winner now, Eddie. You're on to a winner.
Let's move on.
Who's best?
Tomb Raider is set to start filming in 2000. No, it's set to be released in 2018.
Right.
Looking forward to that?
Yeah, absolutely. It's
with Alyssa Vikander. It means you have to start filming next year. Well, I believe it's for release.
Year, wouldn't they? Unless it's like next year filming if it's released at the tail end of 2018.
No, it's going to be for March.
They need to start filming now.
Yeah, real quick. I presume they've kind of been wanting to do this for a while, so I have to presume they've got a script ready.
Are you sure they haven't?
Yeah, man.
Filming?
They've been looking for the right person to cast for the film for a bit of time, so they must have had the script ready.
Mm.
What? How long is it going to take them to film it?
Well, it depends how much practical effects they use, because this is a beginning, and she's going to be, if they're doing a similar storyline to what was the first game, she's going to be on the island, so it won't be, or the effects won't be as extensive
but
you need a whole year.
Not just that. What's the schedule date?
Yeah, so 16th March 2018.
Yeah, 2018. Okay, 16th.
16th March 2018.
Yeah, so you're talking about a year and
year and a half.
Yeah. That's fine. Yeah. Why are we worried about this?
I am not worried.
It's not going to be good either way. So.
Why do you say that?
No, this is a good director though.
Yeah.
Norwegian director. He's got a movie called The Wave. Check it out on Netflix. It's a really good disaster movie. Serious filmmaker, and she's a great actress, so I don't think she's going to get involved in anything that's going to be a waste of her time. It has to be an improvement on the Angelina Jolie versions.
So what's the production company behind it again? Is it Universal?
It's Warner Brothers and MGM.
Okay, together. Warner, MGM.
So Warner learned from March. You know, BVS came out in March, financially did well, regardless of the critics. It financially did well. It's a good time for it to come out, because there isn't going to be a big amount of blockbuster interference there.
Hold on, I thought you were the pessimist. Weren't you always the one who's like, I don't like things until I see the trailer?
No, he's never said that. Words in my mouth.
Did we have this argument when we, this discussion over Battlestar Galactica?
No, that's different. That's something which has already been perfected and should not be tainted by the attempted recreation of perfection. You can't do it. Leave it alone.
And you know what? What's the last main sort of action female film that came out?
Hunger Games.
That's an action movie?
Yeah, it's an action movie.
You've never watched them, have you?
I have. I watched the first two.
So there's nothing
coming.
I've seen
the third one's up on Netflix. I might watch it when I'm sick.
Action, adventurous. Yeah, that counts.
So this is the next main one, right? Because I don't think I could...
Well, I guess you could kind of put Star Wars in there. Because that was led by a female.
Yeah. Well, I'm seriously, honestly, I'm looking forward to this. There's a lot riding on it.
Yeah. And Wonder Woman will be out next year.
Damn. So there's... Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, no, it's not like an unprecedented thing. But, yeah, I'm optimistic for it. I'm looking forward to this.
Mo just nods his head. Why do you nod your head, Mo? You should like...
He doesn't want a film led by women. He hates women.
He does hate women. I've noticed that.
You guys, for someone who's saying that you're pro-women, you guys are forgetting the biggest action movie of last year that was had a huge, strong female cast.
There wasn't one.
Mad Max.
It was like a backdoor female-led action movie. Hey, you doing? Oh, you doing?
Get on here.
I was running this porn. Like, close it, quick.
Now you know what we are. Now you know what you are. You'll never grow old, Michael. And you'll never die. But you must feed.
It isn't an official thing, but the reason why I bring this up, Corey Feldman says it will be a bad idea because of what they've done with Ghostbusters if they made the Lost Boys Lost Girls.
Oh my god.
That's the discussion.
Wait. Is that actually...
It's not an official, this is what we're doing, but it's kind of being out there up in the air, and he's come out saying that he doesn't want that to happen.
Excuse myself while I bash my face again.
Wait, but this... Okay, so all right. So this is just
the discussion.
This is just a discussion. But I think the fan base of this film...
Is there any?
Yes, it's a cult classic.
Yes, but I'm talking about a fan base, people who are fevering for this, people who have posters on their wall.
No, people who dress up. The original is a classic.
Yeah.
We have affection for it, but I'm talking about, is there really a fan base?
Well, when you think about, you can Ghostbuster girls, right? That's fine. Okay, we could go there.
Yeah.
The Lost Boys. It cannot have the Lost Girls as the name. It has to have the Lost Boys to connect. If you throw the girls into it, all right, and just have these... Who knows? It could still be a good film. Absolutely, it could be an amazing film. But I just think to myself, because of that nostalgia feeling...
It's not going to appeal to people who have nostalgia. It's going to appeal to the new generation, the teens of now.
I think we should quite clearly state here that we're not against a all-female cast. We just don't want this movie remade.
Except so.
Wait, why don't you want it remade?
It's a good classic movie.
Yeah, but have you seen any of the other ones, though?
Which other ones?
Two.
Well, they were just like cheap to video sequels.
They were still sequels.
But they didn't have any of the original cast.
Corey,
unfortunately, we know he had a lot of problems.
Hey, he seems pretty enthusiastic about doing it, man. I don't know.
Could you imagine?
Which Corey was it?
The main one.
Feldman or Haim?
Feldman.
Feldman, wasn't Haim the main one? Feldman was like...
Isn't Feldman the Michael Jackson wannabe one?
Yes.
Yeah, he's the one. He stuck with it. Haim was in the first film, but Feldman was the most famous.
So it wasn't what drove Haim to like kill himself, because those sequels were just so bad.
Wait, could you imagine if Kiefer Sutherland is in this?
That's a whole different story.
Could you imagine?
I wouldn't be surprised. I bet he would if they paid him enough money to be the dad of one of the young family.
No, I want him to be the vampire. Then I might be interested.
But they're gonna be girls.
The 24.
It's for the Twilight audience.
That's it.
But I don't think. I think that time came and it's gone.
Hunger Games. Yeah, it's the same audience they're going to appeal to.
Maze Runners.
Again, same audience.
Well, right. Well, you could have a mixture cast, can't you? Because the last one was mainly all boys.
All boys.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one will be all girls.
So instead of having a mother, they'll have a father.
Why not? Let's flip it all. So you wouldn't be interested in this at all?
No. I love The Hunger Games, I love the... Even though they weren't exactly great.
Yeah, you even loved Divergent films.
Yeah, the Divergent films, and even the...
So you love these movies aimed at like teenage girls?
Well, yeah. So
is that because that gives you insight into the mind of teenage girls?
Manipulate them.
So I don't mind it. I'm excited about it, but it's just I just think to myself, I would prefer it if it was all boys.
Right. So you want the women to stay in their place and.
No,
that's what you're saying. That's what you're saying.
I'm going to make a great sound clip when Salim just goes, right. To prefer all boys.
I'm just trying to dissect it in my mind, how it's going to be directed, and I just think to myself, okay, it was called The Lost Boys and they should just carry on with that.
Okay. So moving on to classics, cult classics from around the same period, or about 5, 6, 7, 8 years afterwards. We have Flatliners.
Okay. What did you say there? Okay. It's a war cry for the Sioux Indians. Very macho. It means today.
Today is a good day to die.
So was it, Dave? Was today a good day to die?
Kiefer Sutherland's actually joined the cast for Flatliners. Did you ever see Flatliners?
Yes, I did.
Did you ever see Flatliners?
It's not a great movie.
It's a great movie. I loved it.
Flatliners was a good movie, man.
Yeah. You're on your own.
Why do you like it?
No, it was a good film. Kiefer Sutherland was in it. Julia Roberts was in it. Kevin Bacon was in it. It's about a group of medical students who experiment with crossing over into the afterlife by basically killing themselves.
Yeah.
But flatlining and trying to see who can stay under for the longest, and it had its repercussions because certain... Yeah, doesn't want to ruin it, but it's being remade. Kiefer Sutherland's going to be in it. Do you think that legitimizes it?
There seems to be too many movies being remade now from the 80s.
The issue, right, that I've got with anything that with Kiefer Sutherland in it makes me think that he's the character from 24. I think some characters are just like that. And we've said it before. Christopher Reeve was another one when in any other film, he would always come across as Superman.
That's because the only movie you could name of his is Superman, whereas... Kiefer was famous, very famous before 24.
Yeah, but it has kind of defined him though for a whole new generation of people now.
Do you not remember Ghost 2, Salim?
Ghost 2?
I never saw Ghost 2.
Which is the one that I don't think ever got a release anywhere, but he is the guy who waits outside a petrol station, his girlfriend goes to pay, and then she never comes out. And there's a scene in that movie where he wakes up in a coffin.
Because the
killer goes, if you want to find out what happened to your girlfriend, you have to go through what she went through.
Do you remember that? Oh my god, bring up. What is that film? Because I had that. What is that film called?
I have no idea. It sounds familiar.
You must have borrowed it off me back in the days, man. This is like back in like high school.
I'm blank. I'm drawing a blank.
Even to this day, like if I'm with somebody at a petrol pump and they're going to pay, I keep an eye on them.
So, well, does this make the prospects of a Flatliners reboot more... You know,
I think anybody could be in it, and it just
some people in it. It's got Ellen Page,
right?
Which cool and actress. She generally does good movies.
Very good. Nina Dobrev is in it.
I don't think I could ever see her as anything other than Katrina, whatever her name was.
See, she's another one.
Yeah. So there's a bunch. There's a few other smaller actors up in there, but yeah, they're the two most notable. So you know, it's got an interesting cast.
Where will this madness end? What movie will they say we're going to remake and you will just say no, this is too far?
But why? I don't understand the issue with remakes that you guys have. You've got the original. What does it even do? It doesn't do anything to the original. Think about it. At least you get...
It's like a waste of money. It's a waste of time. Really? It's a waste of natural resources.
Yeah. Listen... Mm-hmm. Would it
bad for the environment?
What if at least there's there's a chance that that film might be actually good.
That for the environment side.
So let's see, the big high profile, I know we're going off a bit of a tangent, but the big high profile remakes of the last 10 years, you've had like Total Recall, you've had like RoboCop.
I'm not mad
RoboCop
at that.
Was good.
Yeah, RoboCop was badly good.
Yes.
Badly good.
Yeah, yeah. And I'll put up with Total like... Recall because Kate Beckinsale, Jessica Biel.
Do you want another one?
It wasn't, but
Dread. You didn't see Dread, did you?
I did see Dread. Wicked. That was terrible.
Dread was great.
Dread, like the one all set in that like big tower block. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
That was a terrible movie.
Are you fucking kidding me?
That was horrendous.
Dude, why became this guy around?
We carry him around because he's articulate and he's good with words. And if it was just you and me, I think the podcast would shut down. Because I'm not very good with words.
I remember sitting there and watching that on holiday in Spain and just thinking how...
You saw it in the wrong environment.
How are people saying this is a good movie? I don't know how Ravi said this is like the fourth time I've watched it while we were watching it. And
Mo, okay, tell me, what was it about Dread that you didn't like?
It was just an uninteresting...
Dude, did he watch it on a laptop?
I don't know.
He did watch it on a laptop.
That's a terrible way to watch a film like that.
Everything about that film was great. It was,
Mad Max wasn't really a remake, but kind of was. So I guess that counts as working.
So that was a good one.
Right. So my point being, let's come around full circle now. Yes, you can make good remakes.
Generally, Ghostbusters works or not.
Generally, they aren't great.
Generally, yeah.
All right.
They're like the exception to the rule.
It's not over yet, Mo. It's not over yet. Do you want to play a game?
How many of these have there been?
Do you want to play a game?
I feel like I've seen so many of them.
The Saw franchise is returning with Saw Legacy, I believe it's being called. I think this is the 8th one. I think, yeah.
Are they hitting Nightmare on Elm Street type territory now?
Dude, if it keeps making money. But the thing is, Saw, I like the Saw films. They're not great films, but I like the way how they do all connect together as one cohesive story. Have you ever sat and watched them all together?
Like Nightmare on Elm Street.
That barely kind of connects together, but these actually do kind of work.
They are just like popcorn throwaway movies. Yeah, you can watch it, it's like fun new ways that they invent to kill people.
Yes, it's kind of like, what's the one where random acts of shit happen? What's that one called?
Oh, Final Destination?
Yes, it's kind of like that. That's another shitty one, but I love because it's just so crazy.
I love it. One of those is really good, though.
I like them all. I ain't going to apologize for it.
I've got to say, each one of those I've seen have been quite enjoyable.
I like the Saw films, man. They're not great. They're not the most... The first one's actually a really good film that stands on its own, but they all connect together in this cohesive sort of story that follows on from the next. Literally, sometimes they pick up from the very scene of the last film before it. Always works and it's so inventive and twisted and I'm not mad at this. No, it's not going to be one that you're going to get excited to go see, but good horror film, man. Why not?
Another remake? I thought you don't like remakes.
It's not a remake. Well,
it's a sequel.
Yeah, it's a new
continuation.
I don't know. I think, haven't we kind of, although I'm, I don't even know if I'm excited about this because I think to myself.
You haven't seen, you only seen the first one.
Well, the first one was good. I agree with what you said about like inventive and creative with the killings and stuff like that, and there were a lot of moments to what I could recall. It's that, you know, when you're like, don't do that, there's a lot of those moments and that gets me excited.
Warriors, come out to play. Warriors, come out to play.
Bruno Brothers are heading up a TV adaptation.
I think you mean the Russo Brothers, not the Bruno Brothers.
Did I say Bruno?
You just said Bruno.
The Russo Brothers, most notably known for the last two Captain America movies, Civil War and Winter Soldier, they're heading up a TV adaptation of the 1979 classic of Warriors.
Now, this is where I'm going to have to say, this has been in my Netflix queue for such a long time.
Are you going to tell me that you've never watched
it? I've never watched it, but it is in my to-watch list.
But you can't go back.
I have seen many, many trailers, and I have seen many people
It's too late, Maul. You need to see this when you were a kid, when you're young enough not to be influenced by this, by the clichédness or the cheesiness of the 70s, yeah, by people wearing flares. And
I don't think, I'm not like Salim, I can watch an old movie and take it for what it is.
Oh, no, you should have seen this when you were young.
You know what, I never even heard of this up until a few years ago.
It's a classic. I love this. Basically, you ain't seen Warriors. New York, 1979, when New York was basically an open cesspit. There's a rally, like a meeting, for all the gangs of New York to kind of get together, think some sort of peace, shit going down, but it all goes to shit. It's basically got this one crew called the Warriors, and they have to make their way home.
So why are they doing this on TV?
Because it means they can have a different gang every episode, because they basically have to try and get their way home from wherever it is that they this meeting is to where their base is, and it's just this crazy adventure. They even made a game, a computer game based on this. That's actually pretty cool. I think the GTA guys made it.
Oh, yeah, I have heard of the Warriors with on their motorbikes and stuff.
No.
No, alright.
So, you think they're going to half-ass this?
It could be interesting. They do seem to have the Midas touch. Everything they touch turns to gold.
Do you think it would be better for them to keep it in the 70s or base it now, contemporary?
I don't know what gang culture is like now in the States. Obviously, in the 70s, it was a very different type of environment. And it wasn't just gangs, it was also about the colour of your skin, it was about your political beliefs, where you lived. I think New York's a very different place
now. Very different. But this is why it worked, because they were just bizarre caricatures of each other. All these different gangs were just bizarre. So that's why I don't know whether this could work in a contemporary. I don't even know if it could. That's why I say you should have watched it as a kid, where you could just forget about that sort of shit. Damn it, man.
Well, there's some great movies from the late 70s, early 80s that you could probably say that about.
I'm looking forward to it anyway, man.
No Surrender, No Retreat.
Ooh.
American Ninja.
Yes.
What was that one about Nemo where they train him and he's like, oh,
Nemo?
Yeah, I no.
Nemo.
Unarmed and Dangerous.
That one's over my head. I remember that Jim Carter.
You gotta watch Unarmed and Dangerous.
I remember Jim Carter, the gymnast who decides to enter a martial arts tournament. And he creates his own gym based martial arts system. That's all. Right, so Attack on Titan Season 2 won't be coming out until 2017. Now keep in mind, Season 1 came out in 2013. Yeah.
So I haven't seen the show, but what's the reason for the delay? Surely everyone would have thought it'd been cancelled by now.
No, it's because it's been the biggest anime of the last 3 years now. It's been a bit of a phenomenon, so I guess they just want to take their time with it. I'm not sure whether they caught up to the comic books too quick.
Production work that's taking so long, or just...
It's just great animation, man. They do it well. Think about when they make an animated movie. It takes about 3 years to make. So I guess they're trying to do that level of quality in the show. But this is another one you should watch, Mo. I'd legitimately advise you to get into Attack on Titan.
Attack on Titan.
Brilliant show. Brilliant show. Bizarre as fuck, but brilliant.
See, that's what I don't like, is things when things go bizarre.
But it's not bizarre in a psychedelic way. It's just bizarre in the world that it's based on. These people that live within this confines of a city beyond the wall. And there's rumours of what's on the other side of this wall, but people haven't seen whatever's on the other side for generations.
Oh, right, so it is like a proper Japanese anime. It's not like an American remake.
No.
Well, last week we were discussing 5 years for Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Yes. That.
Oh, and I have to congratulate you on the choice of sound clip in last week's, in last week's podcast.
Get in that ass, Harry. That was a cool show. That was a good clip.
That was Mr. Black, wasn't it? I think he's one of my favourite characters.
Just to think all of that, most likely he's ad-lib. Makes it even more genius. I love it. So, sorry guys, this one's going to have to be a cut short quick. We're going to have like a talking shit segment at the end where we're just going to talk random shit now that we ain't got Game of Thrones, and we're going to do like a hero villain of the week as well. But
well, let's ask the guys here, give us like some ideas for some segments that they may want us to talk about.
Yeah, why not? Little things that we can deviate at the end of the episode. Alright guys, so for another week, a super cut down version of Talking in the Movies. So later guys.